In this video, we are going to learn the last formulations that we can prepare for topical use, which are the hydrophilic ointments and the gels. We are now in the lowest part of our schema. We are going to talk about the most hydrophilic excipients. They are mainly composed of only one phase, which is hydrophilic, and we can have either hydrophilic ointments or gels, which are those prepared by high amounts of water with a viscosity enhancer. The anhydrous hydrophobic excipients are formulations that are prepared normally by combination of the polyethylene glycols of different molecular weights. They are also called macrogels. Their consistency depends on the molecular weight, so they are normally followed by a number indicating the molecular weight. Those that are of low molecular weight are much more liquid, and those which have a higher molecular weight are much more solid, and also they become more compatible with fats, even though they are water soluble. In the slide, we can see an example of the American Pharmacopoeia, which is the polyethylene glycol ointment, prepared by 60% of polyethylene glycol 400 and 40% of polyethylene glycol 3350. They are mixed together to produce the adequate consistency that we can see in this slide. We also have the so-called hydrophilic excipients of the hydrogel type. They are obtained by cross-linking of macromolecular organic substances or inorganic compounds, and they contain a very high amount of water. It will be between the 80 to the 90% of the total amount of the formulation. Normally, we can use to produce them linear cross-linking agents, which are quite useful. And here we know that the amount of water will condition in the end the rheological properties of the final formula. If the amount of water is low, the behavior will be more elastic, they will be much more solid compared to a high amount of water. If the amount of water is high, then we can assure the suitable extensibility of the formula and also plastic behavior, which is the typical one of an ointment base. In this slide, we can see an example of fat gel. In this case, it's the metronidazole gel, which follows the following formula. In this case, is to prepare a gel containing 1% of metronidazole, which is the API, and the excipients are propylene glycol and neutral gel. Propylene glycol is used as a wetting agent, and the neutral gel is the excipient. So again, we have to go back in the National Formulary to the excipient section to see how we can prepare the neutral gel. Here we see the formula for 100 gram, which contains carbopol 940, propylene glycol, conservant water, and triethanolamine to achieve a final pH of 6 to 6.5. The carbopol 940 is the gel forming polymer or the cross-linking agent. Propylene glycol is the wetting agent. Water is the aqueous carrier, and triethanolamine is used to change the pH to produce the cross-linking of carbopol. And in this video, we are going to see how this gel is finally prepared. So this is the way the carbopol gel should look like after 24 hours after preparation. Because first, carbopol has to swell all over this period. And then we can adjust the pH to produce the cross-linking. First of all, we have to weight the carbomer and sieve it to make sure that it's in the appropriate particle size, to make sure that swelling will take place in the appropriate way. Once the particle size has been reduced and is homogeneous, we can add it to the water and the propylene glycol mixture. We will add it by dispersion, because we have to assure that the whole flux are able to get in touch with water, increasing the surface. If we find some flux, we can reduce their size with the help of the glass tap. We can let it hydrate for 24 hours, and then after that time, we will add the 3-ethanolamine to change the pH. As you can see, this process increases the viscosity of the final formulation by cross-linking of the polymer. And if we check finally the pH, we will see that the value is between 6 and 7. Or 5 and 6. Yeah, 6 and 7.